First, for those ones who have already subscribed to this platform, respect to you guys for sharing out the video, hitting the like button, doing amazing job on this amazing platform. God bless you guys for supporting this platform. I keep saying it time without number because you guys are responding. That is why we keep on bringing information on this platform. All right, but first, before we go to the major article why we are here, I want to remind those ones who are living here in Italy, though I reported this news, I think that was 5 days ago or 6 days ago, something like that. Those ones who are having twins, if you are living in Italy, you have a twins baby and then you don't have documents, just go straight to a lawyer and state to this lawyer. Now you have heard that there is a court who have ruled in a favor of mothers who are having twins here in Italy. Let me give a little bit of the article so that you guys can still understand, though I reported this news, but I just wish to kind of like throw a little bit line to this article here because they republish it again. That is to let you know how serious these people are. All right, he said here, Italian court rules migrants with children must be given protection. Must, you see that word, must be given protection. Let's just read a little bit something here. He said, Italy's highest court has ruled that a migrant mother of twins must be granted humanitarian protection status. The court said the children increase her vulnerabilities. You understand, there are many articles there. I just want people who are living here in Italy, and then it happens to be you are a mother of twins, just go straight to a lawyer. If you're having your case in appeal anywhere, just try to make sure you put this thing into consideration, taking your babies to them, state that you are having twins, and then you had this kind of article, then you'll be granted that protection. So without wasting time, let's go straight to the major article why we are here and see how it looks like. Hi guys, this particular update is not friendly, but we have to state it the way we are seeing it here right away, because it's not as if the game is turning upside down, because the rate at which they are throwing questions to Luciana Lemojese, which is the Minister del Interno, this lady you guys are seeing here on board, is too much, and then that led this lady to give a kind of like some speech which is not a kind of like good for we the immigrants. I'm going to give you guys the update so that you guys can see how all these things are going here. You know, in my I think that was the video I did 3 days ago, I tried to tell you guys that the rate at which this Matteo Salvini is disturbing Mario Draghi, which is the prime minister, to stop the immigrants who are arriving from the sea, most of you did not really believe all those things. I told you guys that these governments, the way they are working, they are not going to be that too good to immigrants. Now, they have thrown a lot of questions to Luciana Lemojese yesterday in the parliament, asking her, immigrants who are arriving from Sicily, arriving from Africa, what do you have to do to these people? Because the rate at which people are being infected again here in Italy, and immigrants arriving in one side. One senator in the parliament was even asking this lady, stating that, you know, you people made Italians to stay at home, not moving to anywhere, but in tanto, immigrants are coming from Africa every day by day, even bringing a coronavirus, you understand? So now let's kick into the article so that you guys can see the question, and then I'll still give you guys the video to watch where Luciana Lemojese was trying to make all this immigration. Lemojese, pandemic flows flowed. The European Union needs to strengthen repatriation policy. Now let's go to the major article here. He said here, the Minister of the Interior, Luciana Lemojese, replying to the question time in the chamber, explained, the government of the phenomenon requires a strong collaboration of EU countries with third countries. First landing states are penalized, and the European Union must strengthen support for the countries of origin of the flux and collaborate in repatriation. You understand? So this place is trying to explain that, you know, this Lemojese is stating that other European Union, they have to come together. Those places where immigrants arriving first, especially this Italy as a case study, they have to strengthen the put the forks or power to repatriate immigrants who are arriving here in Italy. This is what they are trying to state. Let's just finish a little bit about the article, then I give you guys the video to watch as well. All right, he said, this is the position that Italy will support in the negotiation on the part on immigration and asylum with the aim of overcoming the Dublin Protocol on the risk of spreading the variant. Lemojese spoke of the health protocol to which migrants are subjected. You understand? So guys, what they are trying to state is the same thing. Now, let me give you guys the video of Lemojese to watch so that if we come back, we'll try to give more explanation.
Signor Ministro, da un anno i cittadini italiani sono sottoposti a misure di contenimento del Covid. Sono chiusi in casa, i più fortunati devono comunque rientrare entro le ore 22 in un delirio di colori tra il giallo e il rosso scuro. Nel frattempo, nei primi due mesi del 2021 abbiamo visto raddoppiare gli sbarchi, oltre 5.000 individui, noi chiusi in casa e i clandestini che sbarcano liberamente a migliaia sulle nostre coste. Attività chiuse, discoteche, ristoranti, palestre, scuole di danza, tutto il comparto del turismo, solo per citarne alcune, mentre gli altri esperti sono preoccupati da tante varianti del virus, tra le quali anche quella nigeriana. Un danno calcolato in 41 miliardi soltanto per il comparto della ristorazione. Dall'altro lato, inchieste per accertare pagamenti di denaro alle ONG per il trasbordo dei clandestini alla nave italiana Mare Ionio. Ci chiediamo allora cosa vuol fare questo governo per fermarli, ammesso che voglia realmente fermarli. Grazie.
La ministra dell'Interno Lamorgese ha facoltà di rispondere, prego.
Gli onorevoli interroganti chiedono di sapere quali iniziative si intenda porre in essere per limitare il numero degli arrivi di migranti in Italia e fare in modo che sia tutelata la salute dei cittadini italiani e degli stessi migranti rispetto al pericolo di contagio per Covid-19. L'incremento degli arrivi di migranti, in particolare sulle coste siciliane, è determinato soprattutto dalla situazione pandemica che, in conseguenza dei suoi effetti sul piano socio-economico, continua a indebolire fortemente i sistemi nazionali già fragili dei paesi del Nord Africa, alimentando flussi migratori più intensi. Né può sottacersi la grave situazione politica che si registra in Libia, Tunisia e paesi di partenza dei flussi. Pertanto, sul raffronto dei dati concernenti gli arrivi nei primi due mesi del 2021 rispetto al periodo dell'anno precedente, pesa certamente la grave emergenza sanitaria in atto. Su un piano più generale va ribadito che il governo del fenomeno migratorio esige in maniera imprescindibile una forte collaborazione tra gli Stati membri dell'Unione Europea con i paesi terzi. È nota la posizione italiana, da me riferita in Parlamento in occasione di diverse audizioni, riguardo sia ai meccanismi solidaristici di redistribuzione di migranti, ritenuta da noi penalizzanti per gli Stati di primo approdo, sia alla necessità che l'Unione Europea, anche tramite specifici partenariati, rafforzi il suo ruolo da protagonista nelle politiche di dialogo e sostegno ai paesi di origine e transito dei flussi, come anche nelle politiche di rimpatrio. Naturalmente tale posizione, ampiamente condivisa con gli Stati membri dell'area mediterranea, con cui è attivo da tempo un intenso confronto volto a definire una strategia comune, sarà fortemente sostenuta nel negoziato in corso concernente il nuovo patto per la migrazione e l'asilo, il cui ambizioso obiettivo è di superare il regolamento di Dublino. Relativamente ai rischi per la salute pubblica legata alla questione migratoria e all'emergenza pandemica, le misure in atto consentono l'efficacia controllo.
Guys, so that is what is going on right away in the parliament, whereby they are demanding for the protection of those ones who are arriving in Italy. And but guys, one thing you have to understand is that when we are talking about deportation, or when you are hearing deportation, it's not going to be such a way that those ones who have documents, they have to go back to their country. No, you don't have to go back to your country. If you have documents, you are in the country, so they are not going to deport you back. In deportation, we only go for those ones who really don't have documents. I think that should be, because that is why everyone in the country right away, you have to fight in a way, you have to have that 6 months permesso di soggiorno richiesta di asilo so that you can still be online. Because if these people try to kind of like fast forward everything to deport immigrants, and then if the European country try to kind of like support Italy, that is when this thing will really take place. Because Italy will not have only the strength to deport immigrants. Italy not get money to deport immigrants like that, except other European countries put their forks and then try to deport immigrants who are living in Italy. That is when all this thing will come to reality. And then mind you, it will still be for those ones who don't have documents at all. They're not going to just come and deport you or having 6 months document, or you're having 2 years, 5 years. They cannot just deport you like that. And then you still mind yourself that if they are saying that they want to deport people, they must check those ones who are not regular in the country. You understand? So guys, anywhere you are, be careful the way you move up and down, especially those ones who don't even have 6 months document, and then your case is no longer online. please try to make sure you amend your ways of moving and then be a good person, because the rate at which this policia the start to, because I read one statement for you guys where the even the Luciana Lemojezi, they published in her website, they have impact on immigration, that is the illegal immigrants, they have impact most oppression against illegal immigration and drugs dealing here in Italy. So anywhere you are, you have to take careful, you have to take culture, you understand? So guys, this is the update that is coming from Luciana Lemojezi and the parliament, that they have to deport immigrants who are not regular in the country back to their country of origin, for EU country to kind of like support them, that is European Union to support them to take back immigrants who are not qualified to have the asilo politico here in Italy. So without wasting time, let's kick into another update and see how it look like. Hi guys, this update is all about Giuseppe Conte and Mario Draghi. We are going to make election right away. You put your own at the comment section. For me, I like Giuseppe Conte, but for yourself, you have to tell me the person you prefer, either this Mario Draghi or Giuseppe Conte. Because now, the DPCM which this Mario Draghi tried to sign and then put that will be going to force from 6th March to 6th April, most of the leaders of Fratelli d'Italia, which is Giorgia Meloni, have come out to state that, you know, that there is nothing different between Giuseppe Conte and this Mario Draghi. You understand? And then come to see it, is something really kind of like the same, because the same way Giuseppe Conte have to plate DPCM, everything is just the same kind of like thing that this Mario Draghi just did. And then one of the senators was saying that there is nothing different between this Mario Draghi and that of Giuseppe Conte. Say chiuso tutto, chiuso tutto, chiuso tutto. For those of you who have never watched the video, guys, let's try to see the update.
L'ultimo DPCM di Conte del 14 gennaio e il nuovo DPCM del governo dei migliori si somigliano in tutto e per tutto. Stessi colori, stesse parole, stessi contenuti e, purtroppo, stessa filosofia, che si potrebbe riassumere in tre semplici parole. Chiudere tutto, chiudere tutto, chiudere tutto.
The video where this man is trying to state that, you know, there is no difference between Giuseppe Conte and then Mario Draghi. And then you yourself, try to tell me your own point of view. If it's the same thing for you, let me know, because it's very important we know all these things. Because now, if they have to state that Giuseppe Conte was the best, I think they have to be regretting now. Because this man known as Matteo Renzi, who frustrated this Giuseppe Conte to the extent that this man just tried to resign out of the government, the man is not even coming out to state anything based on this issue. So even Savini, they were asking him some questions based on the vaccine, all those kind of stuff. And the man was saying that, you know, they are vaccinating everything. Matteo Savini, we don't know how it did behave. Now, he supported this Mario Draghi, and then he cannot come out to be stating, shouting at anybody, because he's the part of the government. And then most people are complaining that Mario Draghi is not speeding up based on things that he's doing here in Italy. So guys, that is just a little bit update to let you guys know that, you know, Giuseppe Conte was one of the best prime minister for me, but for you, I don't know. That is why I stated that you have to keep your own point of view at the comment section, then we see how all these things are going. If you choose Giuseppe Conte, try to type in Giuseppe Conte. If you are the fans of that of the Mario Draghi, still let us to know. So without wasting time, let's go straight to another article and see how it look like. I make my life.